everybody, BrickLover18 here today, and in this video, I am going to be tearing down my LEGO City. So as you heard from my last LEGO City update, as well as my LEGO Room Renovation vlog, again, part 3 or whatever it is, I am tearing down my LEGO City because I'm going to rearrange the tables, and of course, rebuild the city once the tables have been rearranged. So I'm very excited for how this new city is going to look. Of course, it's going to be over here, along the entire length of the room instead of just in kind of in this corner, which is exciting. It's going to be the exact same size because I'm using just the same two tables, not increasing it or decreasing it. It's actually, I guess, a little decreased because I forgot about the table that was over here. That was part of the amusement park area. As you can see, the dock just goes to nowhere now, and the amusement park has been already taken apart, and parts of it have been placed all over the new, you know, all over the different parts of the LEGO room, with the rest of it probably going on the new bookcases. But I'm really excited to finally add a new part to my LEGO room. You know, these new bookcases are going to mean a lot. Of course, I don't love that I have to redo the city again because it is a lot of work every time I do it, but it's always an exciting challenge, and I'm looking forward to it this time as well. So without any further ado, I'm actually going to start tearing down the city, and I'll pick up the camera in a few minutes to tell you a little bit about some of the progress. It was actually just a little coincidence that a bunch of the vehicles from my city were already taken out from the last, you know, they weren't even in the last update. But that's just a coincidence. It makes my life a little bit easier. Tear down of the city went very messy. As you can see, the whole city's moved. Both the tables are there. I haven't really torn down this part of the city yet. I got a little sidetracked because the opening here is a little bit smaller than I thought it would be when I measured. So I started to get really paranoid that a bookshelf wouldn't actually fit. So I went to my studio, made a huge mess on that side as well, and actually moved over one of the bookcases from my studio. So that's not going to be a lot of fun to put back, but I just want to put it in. I want to make sure it fits, and then I'm going to be really extra and move it all the way back to the other side and fill it right back up so I can get that stuff both off my studio, but as well, just in case this bookcase, you know, this one is a little bit different of white than the other one, because I can't have one off-white compared to the others on my studio. They all have to be the same. I purchased them all, built them all at the same time, so I know they're good. So I'm just going to make sure it fits. I think it will. I just had to take down the minifigures and stuff first, but I think it will fit. And once it does, I'm going to confirm and then move this bookcase right back to the other side of the studio. Great news, it fit just like I had hoped. That's amazing. And as you can see, it lined up perfectly with the green square I put on the floor. So that's awesome. What I'm going to do now is take down all the posters, take down the rest of the minifigures, and probably do some rearranging of the posters because I like these ones obviously way more than the Hobbit and Ninjago City. Make this wall look a little bit prettier, and then pile all the sets towards one end of the LEGO City, the big table now here in the center, and then finish taking off all the black construction paper, taking down the park because I don't know if the new city is going to have it. But overall, this looks really good in place now. It's going to look much better with four, of course, but for just the one right there, it looks great. And then this is what I was saying by on the other side of the studio is now an absolute mess because I got rid of one of the bookshelves because it's now over there. But I'm going to do all the spacing and stuff today. So, and then move it all out. Now that I know it fits absolutely perfect, it is end to end, which was very, very scary. Like it was, you know, I had to shove it in. And then down here, I'm just going to use it for extra storage, probably instructions and stuff like that. As you can see, I've got a whole bunch of instructions there. And then I'm going to do a lot of the rearranging right now to try and get everything thrown under the city, hidden away, and just overall put away before I have to bring the bookcases in tomorrow. But this video is not about the city, but this was, you know, a big part of the city, obviously. If it didn't fit, I don't know what I would have done. But now that that is in, let's tear down the rest of the city and do the rest of that. We are back. The city is still decommissioned. As you can see, first off, posters are up. They look great. The rest of the city is now just kind of moved down here. My next steps are going to be going through all the crap that's all over the floor right now to get that set back up underneath the room here, like underneath the table, because it's pretty empty down there. Overall, really happy with how things are going so far. I'm sorry this video is not more of a, like, actually city teardown video. The city teardown happened really, really fast, and, you know, I did it in just a few minutes, so that's why there isn't multiple parts. And then, as you can see, most of it's just still over here, so this is more, I'm still going to call it a city teardown, but I know it's more of, like, a room rearranging video, and again, I'm just sorry it's so messy. It's, like, absolutely insane, but what I'm going to do now is just kind of work to get some of these bins and air conditioners and stuff back under the table. I'm going to get the rest of the sets over here, and of course move this big stupid bookshelf back to the other side of the studio. Now for the Lego City, I've just got to really go through this park area. You know, I got through the bins already, and I just got to salvage, you know, what I'm going to keep, what I'm going to salvage, what I'm going to keep. So like all the studs and stuff like that, so I can keep them separate, put all the plants in here for when, if I build a new park in the newer city, it's all just easy to find and I don't have to resort and, you know, re-put all the flowers and stuff on and all that good stuff. All right, everyone. So as you can see, the Lego room is kind of a mess. I know I really started off this video saying the majority of it was going to be tearing down my Lego city. I'm sorry that this video wasn't really that in the long run. Like, I know I did a lot more and I talked about a lot more. I didn't get as much done in the city as I thought I might, just because I still wanted to keep my studio for the most part pretty clear because I have still a lot of videos to film. I did get this shelf back up in operational again, which is really great. I reorganized it a bit and I think it looks really good, so I am happy with that. But other than that, I still got lots of new sets that need to be put on the new shelves. Over here, as you can see, the tables are aligned just like I said they would be. I've got this part is just so messy and part city, DVDs, everything. Everything under the table is pretty much organized now. I've just got to obviously move it over all back into place once the bookcases are in. Of course, left spots for the bookcases, that's the exact measurement. Got the posters up, and then just overall lots of things going on in the city. I still have no idea where this light's going to go. I'll figure it out. No idea yet, but as you can see, the second one's over there, and then I've got this one there, and the other one's still on the other side. But it's going pretty well. I also don't know where this bookshelf's going to go, but I know I'll find a place because I'll never leave a bookshelf empty. And then the four bookcases are going to go along this wall, which is going to look really, really nice. I'm really happy with how things are looking so far. Once I get the new bookshelves in part number 3, I will have more of an update for you. And then if like more rebuild updates for the Lego City will be separate videos. But of course, once I get the bookshelves in, everything will just kind of fall together. I'm not sure how I'm feeling about this right now. As you can see, when I look from this side of the room, the Disney castle kind of looks really poor there, but then if I was filming from this angle, the Disney castle looks amazing. So I don't even know if the Disney castle will stay there. I might end up putting another set or something like that. Maybe like the Ferris wheel would be a good set to go there, and the Disney castle could go up where the Ferris wheel is, just because this set, you can look at it from both sides and it's fine, but this set is really one-sided. So I might do some rearranging there, but I do really love that Disney castle. But now I'm really thinking I'll probably put it up there. But anyway, that's all for this video. Thank you everybody so much for watching. I can't wait to get these new bookshelves in, and then part number 3 will be me building all of the bookcases and actually getting things put back together, because right now this room is a disaster, but what could we expect? I really like the way it looks. I think it's a lot more functional, and it'll just be so much more amazing when everything is tidied up and back together. And then I'll finally do a long-awaited Lego room tour. But till then, thanks everybody so much for watching. Come back tomorrow for part number 3 of rearranging the Lego room and adding everything together. And I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next video.